Senhor Santos, que prazer revê-lo. Bem-vindo. Meus amigos estão logo aqui, por favor.
Muito obrigado.
De nada, senhor.
Bom te ver, Otto.
Obrigado.
Five months in Brazil. You're a hard man to find.
Não falo inglês.
You even have the accent, right?
Se tu dizes.
I do say so. The principal I represent has an offer for you. He would like three men killed. Each death must look like an accident. Your specialty, I believe. Seems that reports of your demise have been greatly exaggerated. My principal could make that known to certain interested parties, which means that your new life here would end rather quickly. Or you can do the job and go back to being dead. What's your pleasure, Senor Otto Santos?
Let me make a call.
What are you doing?
I'll tell your principal, you never face the fuck of the dead.
Oh! Fisher.
Who am I?
You're different.
Older.
Something more than that.
I need time to find someone before they find me. And I'll be moving on. Who else is here?
No one. Diving season's over. Come. My home's waiting for you. How was your trip?
It was okay.
It was a busy season. But don't worry. No one came near your home.
Nothing's changed.
Get some rest.
Warika.
Hi. How can I help you?
Great, you speak English. I'm running low on first aid. I'm staying on the boat.
Sure. This is all I have.
Thanks.
If I don't have what you need, I can't call our supply boat.
They can take you back to Phuket to get it. No. This is great. Thanks so much.
Anytime. She has a backbone. Women like that get killed in these situations.
Domestic squabble, May. Not my business.
You helped me once. Help her. Oh, I will do it.
Last chance.
Let go of me, Frank.
You don't want to do that. Fuck you!
Go ashore. I'll do with the boat.
Okay. Your bungalow.
What's going on?
Gina Thorne. American. That's she, right?
Yeah.
You're the second woman that was my picture in a phone. First was working for a guy called Crane. Name ring a bell.
The only thing you got right was my name.
First woman was a messenger. You are. So what's the message?
I already told you.
Tell me about Crane. What are you supposed to do for him? Where is he?
Miles, Hawk! Look, I don't work for Crane. That's the truth, but he did send me.
Where is he?
I don't know.
Why are you here?
He has something on me. I had no choice.
Right. Any of his men nearby?
He didn't say, I didn't ask.
What about Frank?
Part of the setup.
Explain.
He was supposed to get mean. I escaped to this island. It wasn't meant to be real, but then Frank got drunk and attacked me. Crane wanted me to look like a victim.
Get next to me.
Yeah.
Your friend took his part too far. So we meet. What next?
I used the cell and called the pre-programmed number, let it ring once. After that, I don't know.
A new girl gets kidnapped. This what?
What?
Your fault didn't cross your mind?
Okay, so you fall for me, and Crane thinks he has leverage on you. Why?
Force me to do something I don't want to do.
What is it that you do?
I make the call, not you. I choose when they come, and I'll take Crane out.
No, I am not going to help you kill anyone.
Do you really believe that Crane is the people he blackmails into helping him live? I've spent my whole life sending people up to die. I can see you up to live.
My father was a doctor of Eastern medicine. He was a healer. Bishop used to study with him.
To learn how to heal? A man like him?
I thought so too. But my father understood that those who have been hurt the most often have the greatest ability to heal.
Gina Thornton left the war zone in Afghanistan to offer humanitarian assistance in Cambodia.
After my last deployment, I just needed a change. Too many innocent people getting caught in the line of fire. Rules of engagement made it impossible to prevent. And then, you know, when I came to Phnom Penh, it just felt right here. And, I feel like I can maybe do something good with my life.
I can't afford any surprises. I need to know what Crane has on you.
I run a shelter for victims of human trafficking in Cambodia. There's always been an issue or two, but I've managed to handle it. A few weeks ago, one of my staff members was kidnapped. 2 days later, she was thrown off a truck at my front door. Beaten, died within an hour. Crane sent this asshole, Jeremy, who said it was just a taste of what he'd do to everyone at the shelter, including the children. They're my weakness. All the leverage Crane needed. So you see, I didn't have a choice. I had to do what Crane wanted me to.
What are you doing?
On my hand. It's for Crane's people. We're watching.
Where?
Two men in the Zodiac. On the ocean.
All right. There you are. Come on, you two. You're gonna miss the best part. Give me your hands.
We can just get a drink.
No, you will not. You will stay right there. Thank you very much.
What are you doing?
All couples have to be tied together.
But we're not a couple.
It sure looks like it on the beach.
Do you go to weddings a lot?
Not my idea of a good time.
Me neither.
Here. Are
you supposed to drain this?
No. Put your fingertips in it and place three dots on each other's foreheads.
Well, good luck.
Enjoy.
I can use some good luck.
Enjoy.
Thank you for everything.
Everything?
And I wanted to apologize for getting you into this mess. Those kids are everything to me. If they get trafficked or killed, I couldn't bear it.
I understand. I was an orphan too. I was sold to an East End gangster. Specialized in training child soldiers. Crane was there too.
What happened?
I escaped, he didn't. Dad, they blamed him. Took it out in blood.
So now he blames you.
Yeah, this is his payback.
Oh, God. I'm so sorry.
It's not your fault.
are we gonna do?
I worked it out. Supply boat from the backside of the island out of view. But tomorrow night you'll be out of danger. Your kids too. It's all arranged.
What about Crane?
I'm not doing his three kills. Once you're safe, there's only gonna be one. Him.
But they'll never let you near him.
We'll never know I was there. I want you to hold on to something for me until I come back. Father gave this to me. It's the only memory I have of him.
I'll keep it safe.
Trust me. Tell me how to find you face to face.
Listen to her if I were you, Arthur. No need for guards or guns when the man you want's sitting on a pound of Semtex.
Did you find me, Raya?
What, no? Hello, nice to see you after all these years. But then you always were one for getting down to business. How did I find you? You should know better than anyone, Arthur. There's no privacy anymore. What with wonderful things like facial recognition, satellite tracking.
I'm gonna give you something I never give anyone. Chance to walk away. Give me the girl and walk away.
I see you've developed a sense of humor over the years. But if it's all the same, no. I need you. You're the best. Open it. I need you to eliminate three people. And this is the first. His name is Krill, mass murderer and warlord. He's also the highest profile arms dealer in Africa. He's imprisoned on Penjara Kadar in Malaysia. His imprisonment is what keeps him secure. It's impossible for his enemies to get to him.
And this?
It's important that you swallow it only after the kill, or the fuel cell will degrade, and we'll never find you.
Where's Gina?
Do the three kills, Arthur. Get the girl back. Even if you don't love her, you at least owe her, no? I mean, she's in this shit because of you.
How do I know you keep her alive?
And finish a kill, get a video call. After the last one, you'll receive instructions where to find her.
And your word's good, is it?
Good heavens, absolutely not. But I do have a very keen sense of self-preservation. I know that cheating you would only make me your target. And since that concludes our business for the moment, I wish you bonne chance. The prison is 70 miles out to sea, set atop cliffs more than 100 meters high, and surrounded by shark-infested waters. So basically impossible to get in, and nobody has ever gotten out. It'll be even harder to get your man. He's surrounded at all times by his team of loyal soldiers. Getting him alone will be your main challenge.
Under arrest. Vales. Vale. Vale.
to our vessel.
Don't you fucking...
Bishop, remember, it has to look like an accident. If he dies with a knife in his back, no one will be there to pick you up. Good luck.
An executioner for people like Charles Taylor and the Sudanese militia. People say he ate the hearts of his victims. Some have relatives who want revenge. Like that guy over there. He used to be Kreer's best assassin. Now all he wants to do is kill him. But he has his bodyguards constantly protecting him.
A good man. Why don't you join us for dinner?
I'm not sure I like the company.
Then they are not invited.
Come in, my friend. There are 6 murders and 23 stabbings every week in this shithole. Most of them pointed at me. That guy you stopped, he used to work for me. Oh, maybe he's still upset that I killed his brother. Loyalty is a scarce commodity in my line of business.
Oh, yes.
How did you know that he would want to kill me?
I hear things.
My juju tells me everything that I need to hear.
Maybe you weren't listening hard enough.
Do you know who I am?
Krill, you run this place.
Exactly. And when I get out of this place, I'm going to run all of Africa. It could be a job for a man like you.
I already have a job.
What job?
You.
He's right below us. Bring up the net.
Someone. I want my call.
Well, Bishop survived.
Hello, Arthur.
Happy now.
Nice work on Krill.
Prison food will kill you. Put Gino on. Are you holding up?
I'm okay. Crane wanted me to let you know that, you have 36 hours to eliminate the next target, or they will eliminate me.
That won't happen.
Okay, this is all very sweet, Arthur. But you heard what she said. You need to pick up the pace. This is your your next kill, Adrian Cook. Bishop, tell you where he got this. It belonged to his father. I never saw him take it off. Never. You know, I wasn't sure there was anything in the world that could break Arthur until I saw you wearing this watch. Now I know he'll do anything for you. Downtown Sydney, atop a 58-story high-rise, is the penthouse suite owned by Adrian Cook, the mining and minerals billionaire. Few people know that he originally made his fortune in human trafficking, specializing in underage sex workers. He has plenty of manpower protecting him, of course, but that's the least of it. Paranoia is only trumped by his ego. Exhibit A, his cantilever pool. The walls and floors are all concrete, 3 feet thick. Every door is made of 6-inch nickel chromium steel. That's like 12 armor plates. And the biometric sensors and retina readers at the access points are impossible to hack. It's a fortress in the sky.
So each apartment has over 300 square meters of premium living space. But this one gets the Sydney sunset. Specifications are all in the brochure. Let me show you the detailed floor plan. We've got Italian tiles running completely across here. Oh, excuse me.
Sure.
Hello, Samantha Burns. Sorry about that. So where were we?
Well, you were about to tell me about the floor plan.
Oh, yes.
Tree huggers do kick up. Well, they don't. Yeah, that's right.
Now I've got to go.
Thank you.
witness to his death this morning when the glass pool of his Sydney penthouse collapsed. Although authorities are just
giving his call.
Their investigation, a police
spokesman
described Cook's death as a tragic accident, effectively ruling out foul play.
Go ahead.
Bishop, your watch stopped. I think it's a sign.
Maybe it just needs cleaning.
No. Look closer.
Son of a bitch!
Harbour Master's office?
Yeah, it is. How may I assist you?
My name is Tom Shawmer. Some bastard in a bloody grey yard just scraped my vessel. I have the hull number, but my insurance needs the owner's details.
Okay, we'll go ahead.
WRX 489-674-2239.
Okay, give me one moment. The vessel's berth is in Sydney Harbour on Pier 7.
You know your problem, Bishop. You just can't help yourself. So I knew you'd come back for her. That's your weakness.
Now do the third kill, or the girl's dead. Take him down below and give him a proper send-off.
See your little girlfriend again. Now, playtime's over. Go to the port town of Varna, on the Black Sea. That's where you'll find your third kill. His name is Max Adams, a wealthy American arms dealer. On the north side of Varna, you'll find a truly vulgar memorial to Bulgarian communism. Adams spent a fortune restoring it and putting in the most comprehensive security system. But the interesting part is what you don't see. Hidden in the mountainside below is the sub pen. Adams stocks his U-boats with intercontinental ballistic missiles. Nobody gets in or out. Many have died trying. So, needless to say, this will be the hardest site to penetrate, by far. On top of all that, Krill and Cook's deaths may have Adams on the defense. You have 24 hours.
Take out the competition.
Once you reach the compound, you'll have to deal with several layers of security. Has its own power system, oxygen supply, and a state-of-the-art panic room. Good luck, Arthur.
Because he's sitting right in front of me here in the safe room, jack-off.
Magnificent. Even if it is all stolen and looted.
Cubo Future's totalitarianism. Of course it's magnificent. Like, dinosaur bones.
It's ugly.
Who the fuck are you?
I need a talk.
Lose your cell phone? I should have hired those guys in Houston. All right, what is it you want to talk about?
I want to help you avoid an accident.
Krill, Cook, that was you. I warned those guys that one day Crane would come after all of us. Cappuccino, espresso?
Espresso. No sugar. Krill was a warlord, also the number one arms dealer in Africa. Cook used his mining empire as cover to control the Asian franchise. You go Europe, most of South America.
North America, too, if you count Mexicans.
That didn't leave much for Crane. So I have a deal for you.
Well, I'm a dealer. We can talk about it. I've been called a lot of ugly names over the years. Communist, socialist, racist, fascist. None of which is true,
of course.
Well, I'm certainly not a communist.
You just admire their architecture.
I believe in fair play. I saw the David and Goliath story play out on the front lines of Vietnam, Soviets in Afghanistan, ethnic cleansing in Bosnia, and chemical weapons on the Kurds. The little guy is always going to need a slingshot, and somebody's always going to pay for it.
An arms dealer with a moral clause.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about Crane. We both need him gone.
The question is, how do we accomplish that? He's got an army around him.
We need something tempting enough so that Crane uses his men to go after it.
What do you have in mind?
A submarine man. In search for weapons, treasure, your corpse.
What?
You'll have to die.
Well, that's easy. Although it will cost a tremendous amount of money.
You can afford it.
Good job.
Boat's all secured?
Yes, sir.
Batteries charged?
Yes, sir.
Fully provisioned?
Yes, sir.
You get those Russian girls in here last night for the crew?
Yes, sir.
Well, looks like we're ready to go. Stay here.
Came down and he was buried under the water. Gone.
My God. I never imagined that dying would be so goddamn invigorating.
Stay out of sight for 2 days. After that, you can invigorate all you want.
Calling for the driver? Making dinner reservations? Checking in with Mom?
Calling Crane to make sure he takes the bait.
You do know how to put on a show.
There's a pier a few miles north of Vaughn. I'll be there tomorrow with the girl.
Not until I see Adam's body.
You'll find him with his most prized possessions.
And his submarine.
Get over there. Find Adam's body. Secure everything inside the pen.
And, what about Bishop?
Kill him.
Right rear. Take cover!
Anything?
No sign of him, Mr. Crane.
Well, stay sharp. Bishop's coming. You can count on it.
What's going on?
Your boyfriend's coming to die. And you're the bait. Move! The bridge.
Minutes before it blows.
I saw Crane doing something on the console. What's going on?
Crane's trying to kill us. Let's go.
Move this shit on the boat now.
Yes, sir.
What is this?
Just get in.
Wait! What are you doing?
Making sure you live.
No! Come with me! Bishop!
There he is!
Bishop!
Find him, now!
Down there, move!
Right, sir.
Let's get going.
I got out and you didn't. And here we are again.
You deserted me. It's time you paid for that.
No chance. You're gonna get your third kill. This one won't look like an accident.
Dead man, Bishop. You might get off the boat, but you'll never swim far enough away before she blows.
Who said I was swimming?
Survivors? No.
Bishop never made it.
Even legends die.
in Cambodia with the kids. The water filter's working. Thank you so much for your generous gift. You have to come here someday. I think you'd like it a lot. Bishop would have loved it. See you soon, I hope. Lots of love, Gina.
Clever son of a bitch. Sneaky bastard.
Bang.
Dead.